The title of the test is My Best Friend and Me. This is a reading class. So this is going to be a short story and we are going to read together. So let's copy the title, My Best Friend and Me. Right. So now first, raise your hand if you have a best friend. Raise your hands. Quiero ver cuántas manitas tengo. If you have a best friend. Mm-hmm. It can be a girl or a boy. Girl or boy. My best friend is Barbara. Mucha atención. She's tall, slim, and very pretty. Pretty. Do you know the meaning of pretty? What's the meaning in Spanish?
Bonita.
Bonita.
Yes. Bonita.
She has long curly hair. ¿Sabe? ¿Se recuerdan de curly hair? Yes. Curly. No es like colocho, just like onduladito. Curly hair, yeah. I like her because she's a friend when times are go good or bad. She's always there when I need her. She's fashion, she's kind, and she's very stylish, I think. So we are going to find this word on the dictionary, and you are going to tell me the meaning of this word. So let's go. Do you have dictionary there with you? No? No dictionary? Now, my best friend's name is Diane Costello. She's medium height and she has straight blonde hair. I want her like that. I love her because she's good listener. A ver, ¿qué es eso de good listener? Pablo Montana is my best friend. Vean, aquí está Pablo Montana. No sé quién de los dos, pero... Pablo Montana. He's my best friend. He's a year older. I'm 18, but we're in the same college class. We like the same things, soccer, basketball, social networking. Side, he's tall and he has short brown hair. ¿De qué color es el hair de este chico?
Es corto café.
Mm-hmm. Very good. And a great smile. Hmm. ¿Quién creen que es entonces de estos dos? Pablo.
¿El de la izquierda?
Yo creo que este tiene la mejor sonrisa. Entonces sí. Porque aquí dice que tiene una bonita sonrisa. And great smile, right? He's confident. What's the meaning of confident in Spanish? Or confident. You... Do you know the meaning confident? A confident person, what's the meaning of that word? Confident, something, confident, do you know it? No? With your own word.
Es como una
confiado,
segura, algo así.
Okay, when you said to a person que es confidente, ¿a qué me refiero yo? In Spanish, you can say in Spanish.
¿Es confiado?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
¿Es confiado sobre sí mismo?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Choose that.
Es reservado, mis.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For example, imagine that you are telling like all your chismes, gossip. Gossiping with a people or with a person, I'm sorry, with a person. Like, la teacher de inglés me dijo que saqué cero. Mira, So this person is with your mother. Mother.
Ay, fíjate. Que es de confianza.
Que Dylan sacó tal cosa y que no sé qué, y que no sé qué. Ahí va el chismecito.
¿Cómo se siente?
Indirecta.
Dylan sacó cero.
¿Cómo se
siente? No, saqué cero.
¿Cómo? Bueno, pero es cuando uno le... Bueno, digamos que yo le digo algo y le pasa. Entonces ahí ya no soy... Es todo lo contrario de confidente. Confidente es alguien que es reservado, como decían, no le dice el chismecito que me pasó mi amiguito, no se lo voy a decir a nadie, porque me tuvo confianza, ¿sí? Entonces, si dice sus cosas, no es confidente, no es su amigo. ¿Listo? So, he's confident, smart and cool, like cool. My best friend name is Lenny Mason. He's a really nice guy. He's tall, but I'm taller. And he has short blonde hair. He's a very funny guy, and he always looks very cheerful. So now we have another new word. Vamos a buscar esta. What's the meaning of cheerful? Do you have it there with you? Write it on the chat if you have it there. cheerful. What's the meaning of cheerful? A cheerful person. Words that we learned today. Choose the new words. Solo las palabritas que fueron nuevas para nosotros. Like cheerful, like stylish, like we have confident, slim, kind, good listener, good sense. I'm going to give you 1 minute for you to copy. Choose the new words like cheerful, kind, good listener, slim, stylish, sense of humor, confident, great, tall. Yeah, all the new words. Then we are going to do activity number two. Point. You are going to think about your best friend. If you don't have best friend, like I don't have a friend because the people, I don't like the people, I don't know. But if you don't have best friend, think about the perfect person that you would like to have as a friend. For example, I don't have a friend, but I would like to have a person very kind, stylish, confident, cheerful, with sense of humor, good listener, because it's really important. ¿Qué clase de amigo les gustaría tener? Si no lo tienen ahorita, describe in your notebook, like a paragraph, but short paragraph. I would like to have a friend like with these characteristics, cheerful, good listener, kind, with sense of humor. If you have best friend, now describe the characteristics of your best friend. You can use these new words that you know, or you can find another ones in your dictionary. Oh, but here we have a lot. Aquí tenemos varias cositas que ustedes pueden utilizar. So you are going to have 2 minutes and I'm going to check the paragraph. This is going to be the last time. The last activity, the title is My Best Friend and Me. Este es the title. Please write it at the beginning. My Best Friend and Me. Then you are going to start describing your best friend. Or if you don't have best friend, just think about the person that you would like to have in the future. That's a friend, like not now, but in the future, maybe yes. So let's do it this and you tell me finish when you finish.